Welcome to our next video in the series on trigonometric substitutions. So let's suppose that we're asked to evaluate the integral of dx over x squared times the square root of 9 plus 4x squared. So what we're looking at in this case is really the expression under the radical. So if we're thinking that we have something like 9 plus 4x squared, well, if I factor out a 9, that's going to give me 1 plus 4 ninths x squared. And if I rewrite that as 2 thirds x quantity squared, then what this reminds me of is the trigonometric identity of 1 plus tangent squared of theta being secant squared of theta. And so it's this trigonometric identity that I have 1 plus something squared, 1 plus tangent squared, tells me really what my substitution is going to be, and that is namely that the tangent of theta is going to be 2 thirds x. So if I have that the tangent of theta is going to be 2 thirds x, then kind of taking the derivative of both sides, then I've really got that derivative of tangent gives me secant squared of theta d theta is going to be equal to the derivative on the other side, 2 thirds dx. Or another way of looking at that is that dx is just going to be 3 halves times secant squared of theta d theta. So now kind of coming back to our original integral, that what we have there is we have the expression now for dx. So we've got that one covered. So the dx, we now know what that one is. It's going to be 3 halves secant squared. The 2 thirds x is going to be tangent of theta. And so that also tells me that just plain old x is going to be 3 halves tangent of theta, and so x squared ends up looking like 9 fourths times tangent squared of theta. And then finally, underneath the radical, we've got the square root of 9 minus 9 plus 4x squared. So 9 plus 4x squared, when we make that substitution of x being 3 halves, then what happens? We've got a 9 plus 4, and we have a 9 fourths tangent squared. Well, by the time we clean this up, our 4s cancel. We get the square root of 9 times 1 plus tangent squared. And that square root of 1 plus tangent squared becomes secant squared, which, taking the square root now, just gives us 3 times the secant of theta. So now we're actually ready to make the conversion for all the pieces into our integral. So our dx, we said that was going to be a 3 halves secant squared of theta d theta. Underneath, we then have for x squared, we've got a 3 halves tangent of theta. And then for our square root, we had 3 secant of theta. And so now we just have a matter of, squared. So we just have a matter of kind of simplifying this integral. So we've got our 3 halves, our 9 fourths on the bottom becomes a 4 ninths times that. We've got a secant squared on top. We've got a tangent squared on the bottom. And then we have another 3 secant of theta, d theta. So our 3s cancel, our 2s cancel. So that's going to give us a 2 ninths times the integral of a secant will cancel. So we have a secant of theta on top. And then we have our tangent squared of theta on the bottom. So now if we convert that into sines and cosines, what we find is that we've got a 1 over cosine in our secant, and our 1 over tangent squared becomes a cosine squared over sine squared d theta, which if we cancel our cosines, now we have a 2/9 integral cosine of theta d theta on top and a sine squared of theta on the bottom, which doing a u substitution, now with u equal to sine of theta, so the du becomes cosine of theta d theta, then we get a 2/9 times the integral of 1 over u squared du. So our integral of 2/9 of 1 over u squared du, when we do that integration, we just end up with a negative 2/9 times a 1 over u plus our arbitrary constant, which coming back to our original trig substitution gave us a 9 sine of theta in the denominator, a 2 on top, plus our arbitrary constant. And so now we need to figure out what sine of theta was in terms of our original variable x. Well, our trig substitution was that the tangent of theta was going to be 2x over 3. Now, if I draw a right triangle that actually corresponds to that situation, well, I've got my angle theta there. Opposite side for tangent is going to be 2x, the adjacent side is going to be 3, and my hypotenuse then becomes 9 plus 4x squared. So that if I wanted to know what the sine of theta was going to be, well, it's going to be the opposite over the hypotenuse, which gives me 2x over the square root of 4 plus, or 4x squared plus 9. And so now I can take that final expression and plug it in, so that really my 1 over sine becomes the square root of 9 plus 4x squared over 2x. So I can take this, plug it back into my integral, and I will arrive at my final answer, which in all of this, I started with the integral of dx over x squared times the square root of 9 plus 4x squared. And here I had this as a negative 2/9, 2 over 9 sine of theta, plus our arbitrary constant. And when we make that substitution, now I've got a negative 1 over 2/9. My original expression for 1 over sine then was going to be my square root of 9 plus 4x squared over a 2x plus my arbitrary constant. So in this case, now my 2s will cancel, and I end up with a final answer of negative the square root of 9 plus 4x squared over 9x plus our arbitrary constant. And so when we've got an expression that involves a constant plus some variable squared, we know that one's going to lead us to a trig substitution with x is equal to some expression involving tangent, so that our trig identities match up to our 1 plus tangent squared. So I hope this has kind of walked you through one example. You kind of see what happens in this situation, and I will see you guys next time.